In this video, we'll be talking about how logistics for Amazon sellers was affected in 2020 due to, well, situation everybody knows, COVID-19. And our guest today is Amit Rosenthal. He runs a logistics company called Rosenthal. And Amit will be sharing what has changed and what we can expect from 2021. Also, what especially new Amazon sellers has to pay attention when they are planning their shipping of their products from different countries, how to save costs on this. So this conversation is a lot from the perspective of Amit, the owner of logistics company, how it changed or how the 2020 changed their business. So listen to this conversation hosted by Lizeth Lees. She works with different Amazon brands. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel of Orange. Click the notification bell as well, because here we talk to different Amazon experts and service providers and software creators.
Hi, Amit. It's great to have you here today. Perhaps with a couple of words, could you share your background and what you do in the Amazon space?
Yeah. Hey, first of all, thank you for having me and thank you for the time here. So my name is Amit Rosenthal. I'm an owner of Rosenthal Logistics Company. We are a firm that handling specific Amazon sellers and e-commerce sellers in general, rather Shopify or other platform used by e-commerce sellers. And we are doing logistics. Mainly, our main job, of course, is depend on the client itself and the seller itself. But let's say that 90% of the sellers selling via Amazon platform in the US, UK, Germany, Canada, or wherever are selling as private label. And let's say that 85 to 90% of them manufacture in China. So our main activity is, of course, export from China to Amazon warehouses around the world, or to 3PL warehouses, of course, depend on the client needs. But in general, we're doing logistics.
Okay, very good. I think that's a great overview of what you do. So today, we meet here to talk about the effect of the pandemic to logistics, both in short term and long term. So maybe for introduction, like when was the point when things started to change, let's say, for your company, and when did you start to notice like bigger changes for logistics and how Amazon sellers were able to send their products to Amazon?
Yeah, so this is a great question, and only this topic we can cover like in 2 hours or so. So I'll try to summarize it better, but I can say definitely for sure that 2020, at least I'm sure that in other fields, but for sure in regard to logistics, maybe it was the craziest year ever. Like, I'm in the logistics business in general more than 20 years. So I can say for sure that this year was chaotic like never before. And in regard to your question, like the pandemic started in China around last CNY, which was around end of January 2020. We started to have some feelings that something is going on there, but of course that it really wasn't concerned to the whole world and to logistics. In that short time, around February, when the Chinese people returned to work, so there was some delays with the manufacturers and some factories, the employees didn't come back to the factories. So some delays were occurred in regarding to the production itself. But definitely things started to go wrong or problematic around the end of March, start of April, when Amazon specific started with a lot of limitation regarding product they receiving. It was start with essential products, and then it moved to the limitation of the product Amazon was willing to receive into their FBA center. And what it did, and honestly, if I must put the cards here, to open my cards here, so this change was very good, specific to logistics and to my company, and I'll try to explain why, all right? What happened was that something around 80 to 85% of the whole cargo going out to Amazon warehouses in general went to the FBA center directly. And maybe 15 to maximum 20% of the other goods were sent to 3PL warehouses, usually just for storage, and then send the goods to the FBA center. And some, of course, did also FBM. But the limitation by Amazon shift the whole process because of the limitation now. 80 to 85% now of the goods sent to the 3PL, and maybe 15 to 20% of the goods sent directly to the FBA center. And this this scenario, basically what it happened, first of all, it make the whole logistics chain much more difficult to handle and to control by the seller, right? Because it's easier, of course, just to send, I don't know, 100 cartons and sell it, all right? But now you can send maybe 20 cartons, and now you need to handle the logistics with the 3PL itself, be more on the spot and monitoring your production and your selling rate and so on, in order to control better your logistics, and in order to try to be always on stock. And honestly, it's difficult these days. So maybe I think maybe if I'm trying to summarize this point, the real major obstacle that the pandemic did here is the movement of or shifting the goods from the FBA center to 3PL warehouses. This is one issue that happened. Second issue, yeah.
I just wanted to ask, can you give us a brief overview? What kind of limitations Amazon implemented, and what's the situation right now?
So Amazon implemented, basically, they advised that new products, all right? If you're launching new products, doesn't matter if you are the best seller on Amazon or a new seller, if you're launching now a new product, you can send maximum 200 units. 200 units is nothing, of course. And there is another limitation for any seller with experience, seller with history on Amazon. And this is based on IPI score. It was 500. And then they advise you how many units you can enter into Amazon. But for sure, doesn't matter if you're a new seller, expert, or advanced seller, the limitation hurt you quite dramatically. We are handling more than 500 clients. I'm doing a daily phone calls with sellers. Assist me finding new 3PL. Assist me, give me advice. How should I split the cargo? So if I'm talking now, by the way, if I'm talking basically based on my experience only as a freight forwarder company, the pandemic did us good, and the reason for that if, for instance, because of the limitation, all right, you have 100 cartons, all right? So up until the limitation by Amazon, so it was one shipment, C shipment, for instance, all right, 100 cartons, let's say to FBA Center FTW1 in Dallas, and that's it. But now it's became, for sure, two shipments and sometimes even three or four shipments for the same amount of cartons, all right? So for me personally, for our company, it did very well, the pandemic, I'm sorry to say, but for the sales, for sure, it is a chaotic situation. But you know, the people, the seller that sell only on Amazon and focus only on Amazon, they are controlled by Amazon, of course, and they need to act accordingly. So basically, this is the situation Amazon implement, and they just need to act accordingly. There is no other solution.
Is there a lot of confusion going on regarding how to choose a 3PL for Amazon Business? Because I imagine if sellers haven't done that work before, they haven't had the need before, then now they're suddenly facing this kind of issue, especially heading to quarter four, and we're already quarter four right now. So there's a lot of things to think about, to calculate, and to manage, right?
First of all, for sure. Second of all, you know, in my opinion, you know, a seller have a lot of his mind in regard to manage their own business, all right? So logistics, usually it was a term or a subject they give it to the freight forwarder or give it to the shipper or supplier, and that's it. They bring the cargo and that's it. But now they need to understand how the 3PL quotation is look like, what does it mean, how to choose a 3PL, where should I choose the 3PL located based on where is my FBA center normally, the type of service I receive from the 3PL. You know, I hear so many stories, especially now with the Q4, that the 3PL doesn't answer them, and they want to send stock and nobody answer them. So many, many, many critical issues happen there. I think also the 3PL owner couldn't imagine the booming of the high intensity, capacity they will have. In this regard, Amazon did them a huge favor, but Q4, I think, show the face of the 3PL itself, meaning now you can sure for the next year or so, and we'll discuss a bit later on prediction in regard to 2021, but for sure in regard to 3PL, in my opinion, this Q4 was at least a test for the next year, because if you were managed in a 3PL warehouses, you didn't get replies, they didn't manage your stock well, so you should look for somebody else, because eventually, if the limitation will still remain the next year, the 3PL maybe is the key point in order to have a good success business at Amazon.
Based on your experience, can you give any tips to sellers what to look for when starting to look for a 3PL for their business, and what's the process look like? Is it just I have to go to Google and start looking by location? Is there any other way, database perhaps, to look up all different options, or how would you approach when you would have to choose a 3PL for yourself?
So like we are also provided the 3PL services, but our capacity, both our warehouses are full, and we cannot receive any new clients in regard to 3PL, all right, at least for the next year. But if you ask my opinion, so there is three maybe key points to check. First of all, in my opinion, the best thing to do is to check where is usually you send inventory to which FBA center. Meaning if usually Amazon requests your site by the shipping plan to send to warehouses in California, there is no any reason to send goods to 3PL at New York, right? So you need to find a close 3PL close to your Amazon warehouse, right? This is the first key. Second key is like you choose a freight forwarder or any other service provider. You need to see and to check the communication with the 3PL itself, all right? That you will for sure have a key contact and good communication, because again, in this time of the year, you want somebody that will answer you and provide you, with the service that you are looking for, right? So in my opinion, this is the key point. And the last and the free key, of course, is the rate. Like if you choose a 3PL that the rate is free or 200% higher than other 3PL in the same area, so it also should alert you with something that is not okay.
Okay, actually, that's good. You brought out the cost. So, what have done the shipping rates, generally speaking, during this year? Have they increased, decreased? What do you think? What's the trend looking forward?
This is first of all, the rate increased, but really dramatically. I will give you an example of numbers, all right, in shortly. But the main reason it happened is because of the pandemic, and what it bring in order to the rate increase so dramatically, all right? First of all, in Los Angeles, all right? Los Angeles, the port in Los Angeles, all right? The seaport in Los Angeles, named Long Beach, all right? So this is the main port in all of United States. Around 60 to 65% of all goods entering into US go to the Long Beach port, all right? So starting September, all right, start to be at Los Angeles, huge, but I'm telling you, huge, huge congestion issue in the port. And it's bring huge delays and extra charges implemented on the cargo itself, all right? More specific, all right? I know it sounds crazy, but because of the pandemic, what happened usually then when a container arrives to port and the vessel discharges the container to port, all right? The shipping line provides demurrage fee. What does it mean? Demurrage fee meaning that from the moment the container landed on the surface, all right, the shipping line provides something usually in the US provides around 5 days until the container needs to return back empty to the port, all right? The shipping line, and then the shipping line started to debit $200 per day, etc. All right? Shipping line do that in order to have a availability of container, empty container, so they can shift it all around the world. What's happening now, there is a lack of containers in China, all right? And because of that, the space on the vessel is super tight, all right? Because of all the things that I'm just implemented now, the rates decrease. And now I'm talking only about ocean freight, all right? We need to consider, of course, the local charges in China. We need, of course, to consider the local charges in the US, okay? But just for you to understand, if I'm talking only about ocean freight, let's say from Shenzhen to Long Beach port, all right? By the end of June 2020, all right? The rate for 40 high cube container was around $2,000. These days, shipping line sell same exact container, same route, $4,200, all right? So the rate increased almost double, if not even more. I can say that we sell, again, I don't want to talk about numbers, but I can say that we sell to ONT8, all right? ONT8 is a warehouse in Los Angeles. We sold ocean freight per CBM, all right, around June, July, $100 to $120 per CBM. Today, it can reach even to $200 per CBM. So the rate increased dramatically. Let's say if we're talking about prediction here, all right, so next month, January, is close to saying why the rate will be the highest. Then the Chinese people will go to the CNY, no production. Again, on March, there will be a huge position for space and for vessels and to ship goods out of China. So the rate will be remaining high level, if not even higher. Prediction, I can say maybe around April, May, the rate may be decreased, but of course for the shipping line, as long as the rate is higher, they have higher revenues. So prediction-wise, I cannot predict the rate will decrease at least before the mid of 2021.
Okay, so hearing you, do I understand correctly that sellers have to consider there might be higher shipping rates overall when they're, let's say, doing a product research and they're calculating the profitability of their product, and also they have to consider there might be extra costs to ship the product from China, not directly to Amazon, but through 3PL, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I'm sure that you know also, sellers usually said, logistics is maybe, you know, overall, you know, of Amazon's seller business, the logistics was maybe 8%, 10%. Usually it was calculated by 15 to 20% of the product itself, the logistics wise. Definitely the percentage went higher and higher. Easily it can take something even 40% of the margin. So, you know, now, in my opinion, products that have, in general, you know, a low profit margin, I don't see it workable for 2021, mainly because of the logistics, you know, because if you had the margin of, I don't know, $5 to $6 per unit, And I don't know, now the margin would be maybe $3 to $4. It's decreased, you know, almost half of your profit. So I know from sellers now that they are looking for product with high margin because of this issue, and in order to have better revenue eventually by the end of the year.
And as we were talking about predictions, then what do you think, will Amazon change anything soon regarding to the limitation? Will they drop up the limitation? Probably not yet. What's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, this is the question, like in regard to my field itself. And as I advise you that the limitation did good to my business. So of course, if they would cancel the limitation, it will be the other way around. Honestly, like Amazon, you know, major part of the revenue is coming from the storage fee and the FBA process itself. So Amazon should have all the desire, all right, to cancel the limitation eventually, all right? Now with the vaccine going to start, you know, in the United States and Europe, like in the next 2 weeks or so, if not even started in some places, like I can only predict that the life will resume normal around mid of 2021. So maybe the limitation will be canceled then. Nobody knows. This is the question, you know, for this year, in my opinion. But I predict that eventually they will cancel the limitation because they should have all the desire to cancel it because they will, of course, have higher revenue eventually and profit.
Okay, everything makes sense. So, Amit, do you have anything else you would like to share with the viewers, or do you have any tips to give out regarding how to manage the logistics during these times right now?
Yeah, sure. So, first of all, you know, sellers in general, all right, I can say today definitely, sellers in general like to wait to the last minute. Sometimes it's because of funding, you know, funding the goods itself when manufacturing until they're selling the product itself on Amazon and receiving the revenue. Sometimes it's just a method, right? But sales need to change the way of thinking, because as I advise, there is major delays with the logistics, mainly because of the congestion issue at Los Angeles. So I can say, for example, all right, that if sea shipping to LA area usually takes something between 22 to 30 days max, all right, from the goods departure from China, today it can reach to 40, 45 days sometimes, to the East Coast, and can reach even 60 days and more. And the worst thing can happen is to be out of stock, of course. So in my opinion, sellers must push their suppliers to start production early, shipping the goods earlier than normal, all right? Don't take just 30 days or 40 days, take 60 days, all right? In order to be on the safe side. This is the best advice I can provide to the sellers here. Don't wait to the last minute. I know in logistics, everybody are hairy, everybody are super, super stressful and so on. But don't make my life easier, all right? Make your life easier for yourself. The main goal for myself also as a service provider, and the main goal for the sellers itself, to be on stock all the time. And again, the situation, you know, I have sellers that selling on Amazon for 8 years, 10 years and more. Everybody said to me, what is going on? So I try to explain that the situation in this year was never like ever before, and sellers need to adjust to the new situation. They cannot just said, all right, we accustomed to something in the past, we know how things going, everything will be okay. No, I'm telling you, everything will not gonna be okay, and you need to adjust yourself accordingly.
Well, thank you very much for sharing your thoughts and your experience as you are right in the battlefield. So if any of our viewers would like to reach out to you and get help, then what's the best way to reach out to you? And perhaps once more, could you explain how do you exactly help Amazon sellers with your service?
We are logistics services, so we can only support our client with better logistics, optimizing their cost. But in my opinion, my biggest job as a company owner is to provide advice to the sellers. Some sellers have a more simple question: how do I open a shipping plan? But let's say if I'm talking more advanced seller, as I advise now with the limitation of Amazon, they have production, 100 cartons, 1,000 cartons, 5,000 cartons, doesn't matter. So usually the request for advice: how to split the cargo? Should I ship some by air, some by express, some by regular sea? Usually trying to understand their selling rate, to understand their experience, and by that, trying to optimize the shipping cost and the shipping method in general. And in regard to how contact us, I will share my email and my assistant's email here in the link below. Provide my phone number and everybody can feel free to contact me via Messenger, WhatsApp, email, or any other, Twitter or wherever.
Great. Well, thank you very much for your effort to help Amazon sellers during these difficult times and perhaps confusing times as well. So we wish good luck in your business.
Yeah, you too. Thank you very much again.
I do hope this conversation was useful for you. And if you're looking for a logistics company for your e-commerce business, Amazon business, check Rosenthal. You will find the links and contacts below in the description. They will be happy to give you a quote or help with your logistic questions. And now I would like to invite you to watch the other video we did about logistics, also with Amit, and maybe you will learn something more and get some good tips. See you.